Hey guys, I hope you're ready for Catacombs action number 2. I don't know why I'm being so cautious. I do, as a general rule, know what's going on here. Yeah. Skeletons in each of the rooms. Spice statue. If you want to solo a proud knight, then you just gotta take the hit. Alright. This will eventually be open, but for now it's not. And in here are a whole bunch of skeletons. However, if you're careful and you move slowly, you can take them out one at a time. So just edge forward. Let them come and get you. Come on. Well, you made an awfully big deal about that, didn't you? Oh, good. I've got a lot of weapons here. Okay. And these two statues are both going to try and spike you, so roll through them. And then roll back out. And continue on your path. Now, usually at this point, you'll find yourself getting a few more souls than you're used to, because one skeleton will kill himself. Pop in here and push the switch. Now you've got two choices. If you head down that way, you'll find yourself on a path that will lead to the blacksmith, the skeleton blacksmith. And he's cool, he does fire weapons and chaos weapons. However, I've forgotten to bring some stuff with... Actually, you know what? Oh no, I don't want to go to see him just yet anyway. Other things to do. We'll come and see him at another point, guys. Yeah, head this way. Where are we? We're here. You can go that way, and that'll be a shortcut we're taking soon. However, before we do that, there are two things to do in this area. Firstly, another switch to push. It's going to switch that bridge ahead of us. Lovely. Thank you. And secondly, here's this wall. Watch out for that statue. And light the bonfire. Yeah. Okay. Whew. I hate the catacombs. Okay, so once you've done that, you can go this way. And this is basically the long way round. But you know, there are things to do. People to see. So, I'm gonna show you it all. Oh, you took a big hit. You know what? I don't want it. I really just don't want it. Invisible wall there. Skeleton archer. Floaty heads here. Let them come and get you. There are a whole bunch of skeletons over there. Okay, well that floaty head doesn't want to explode. That one does. Right, any more skeletons to go? No, I don't think so. So, run your way around here. No items, no hidden paths, don't worry about that. And on into here, and very excitingly, I have something to show you. Now, the Titanite Demon does look intimidating, but don't worry about it. Because we're coming here, and we're going to nestle in this coffin. Oh, how snug. Okay, so that's going to take about 30 seconds of resting in the coffin the first time you do it. Okay, and that brings us to here, the Tomb of the Giants. This is where we're going to fight Nito eventually. However, for now, we're just going to run around this way. And you can pray to the sarcophagus Gravelord. And that's how you will enter the Gravelord Covenant. I'm not going to enter the Gravelord Covenant, even though I'm a fan of it. I am a big fan. But that's how you do that. And now we're actually getting very close to having seen all the covenants, which is impressive. So once you're done here, pop back in. You'll only really want to come to this place to join the covenant and then level up. The annoying part is you can only warp to this area once you have killed Nito. And once you've killed Nito, you can't level up in the Gravelord Covenant. So it's sort of a lose-lose situation. Which means that if you want to level up in this Covenant, you have to kill... Basically, you're going to want to kill Basilisks and get Eyes of Death. Alright, anyway. In here, just wait for a second or two. These skeletons will climb up the ladder, and once they're up at the top, kill them. Otherwise you're going to find yourself down there with two of them. Lovely bit of reach on this. Okay. I don't remember this too well. Yeah, there we go. Okay, you can fall down there. Or down there. You can fall down either way. Let's just go and fall down. Holy crap. Okay, well this is a terrible place to have fallen down. So you fall down into this place with this Black Knight here. Kill him. Oh, white titanite chunk. I actually wanted one of those. Okay, and look at where you are. You're in an area full of pinwheels. Now, pinwheels, as you will already know, because we have done a couple of places with them before. These guys are possibly the most annoying enemies in the game. Oh, can I not reach him? I can reach him. These ones don't have as much health as the guys in the Painted World of Ariarmus, which I suppose is fairly fortunate. There are quite a number of them. Make sure you kill them all. Well, not all of them. You don't, the ones that I'm killing at the moment, you don't actually have to kill. However, if you do, that's going to actually simplify something a little later on. Because we have an NPC to call in. Oh, stop moving. Stop, Mike, you're making this really hard to do. Anyway, yeah, shoot these guys as they're running away from you. It'll take a bit of time, but it's well worth it. Oh, I can't. I just can't. Ah, just sure. There we go. Okay, he's moving. Don't rush down here. It's gonna end in tears. Alright. You, I think you're the last one. And now you're dead. Oh, alright. If you do make the mistake of running down, just stop here. And you'll be able to kill them from this area. But yeah. And really, really annoying. Oh, and I've picked up the, oh, that's good. That's good. Okay, well, if you wanted to go and kill the boss now, you could. That's actually where the blacksmith is. I couldn't remember whether you could break the wall yourself. Looks like you can't. Anyway, you don't have to go and kill Pinwheel just yet, I don't believe. We can come up this way. Shield up, because there are some guys in here. And they're not looking to make friends. Another skull lantern. Wow. My lucky day. Shield up, as always. Can't trust those skeletons. Ooh. Alright. I've already fallen down there. Is there a ladder I can take? Yes, there is. Okay, and then, well, this is where we came in. Blimey. Things aren't going as smoothly as I'd hoped. And now, we must kill the Titanite Demon. You've got something I want, pal. This might take a while, guys. I might have to skip forward through this. Okay, and yeah, there we go. He's down. So, kill him. If you kill him by range, that's just going to save you a lot of trouble. And you get Demon Titanite off him, and if you're lucky, you get the Catchpole, which I did. Very fortunate. And at the end of it, you get some Eyes of Death. And there's nothing there. So let's continue. I'm actually looking for something now. No, nothing there. What is it? Is it this way? No, it's not this way. Let's head back out. There are other things we can do. Right. Yeah. We're going this way. If you want to call in Paladin Leroy, which we'll be doing, but for some reason I feel the need to tell you now, you go onto this platform here ahead, and you flip off to the right. Down where you saw that item. Okay, let's do this. I hate this part. Okay, yeah, take the skeletons out, and then I would normally come and take out this guy as well. Because I really don't appreciate someone shooting me while I'm trying to do my business. Okay. Alright, nothing else going on there, I don't believe. Glowy lights. They're nothing to worry about. Okay. Now in here, don't rush forward, because you'll find yourself with him landing on top of you. So just edge forward a bit, let him drop down, and then take him out. Oh, you're dead. Idiot. Okay, he's the only giant one there. There's that path there, which we will take. That's where he normally falls down. Dark Moon Seance Ring. That's exactly what I wanted. That's going to let us join another covenant. My goodness, I've shown you a lot of covenants, haven't I? I hope you guys remember everything. Well, you know what? You don't have to remember everything, because they're on videos on YouTube. So forget I said that. Make sure you kill him. He's one of those sort of hidden necromancers. Alright. That's a dead enemy, I think. Yeah. There are dead skeletons down there. We've already been there. Let's take this ladder. Because it definitely takes us somewhere. Interesting, I think. Oh, I think this might take us to the Great Scythe. And wouldn't that be something? These statues. Yeah, just be wary of them. Ah, right, tranquil walk of peace there. Hole down here. Skeletons here. Oh, this area is actually right at the beginning. I'd forgotten about this place. Okay, well, come on then. Let's do this thing. Ugh, what a pain. Well, never mind. We're making good progress here, guys. If you can believe it. Sadly, I did rest that bonfire, which has left me with a few more enemies to take care of than I would have liked. And he did make it. Okay. It shouldn't take too long anyway, we know what we're doing. There are a lot of skeletons in this place. Just don't let them worry you. And yeah, what shall we do? I'm gonna follow the proper path because there is just a little more for us to be getting on with. Not much though, we're very, very nearly finished with this area, if you can believe it. Although I feel like I've now said if you can believe it twice. Which is making me sound a bit stupid. Okay, so drop down here, and then drop down here, because sometimes a skeleton will follow you down there. And we get the Great Scythe there. Down there's where we pushed something in. Fall down this hole. And we just end up out here. Look, perfect. And I know I haven't shown you the skeleton blacksmith, but I will in due time. But for now, we're doing this. All of the bone wheels, or pinwheels, I forget what they're called, are dead. Paladin Leroy here. Let's summon him. Absolute badass. Honestly, he's just the toughest guy ever. Okay, and there was an item. There's an item just here. Come on, edge forward. And we get the priest's outfit and the mace. So if you didn't start as a priest, that's how you get that stuff. Why you'd want that stuff is a different question. But the point remains, that's where it is. And let's go fight the boss. Oh wow, what a big session I've done today. This is my fourth boss. Come on, Leroy, stop fucking about. Leroy loses health because he's not very good at dropping off areas. Useless son of a bitch. Yeah, So that's Pinwheel. Now I believe this guy is actually weak to Pyromancy. But to be honest with you, he's actually weak to almost everything. So, take out his copies. Take him out. And don't panic. You will normally have time to heal in this fight. So there we go. That's all it is. All it takes. And you get the Rite of Kindling! Excellent. It's about time. And a Humanity and a Homeward Bone and Mask of the Mother. Which I think increases health. Let's have a quick check of that, I could be wrong. Yeah, slightly raises HP. And now, yeah. Now we come to the Tomb of the Giants. And obviously, I mean, the session's gone on for a while. However, I'm not going to leave it there. I'm going to show you guys how to quickly get to the next bonfire, which is, I'm sure, what everyone will want. The reason I went to Lost Isolith first is so I could get my hands on this Sunlight Maggot, which is going to save me from having to use the stupid Skull Lantern. Now, first things first, come down here, kill this guy. Okay, and then don't kill anyone else. Just run down here, run down here, run past that guy, run past that guy. Turn to your left, and come down this ladder. Okay, just make sure you sort of stay calm. Otherwise these skeletons are going to cause you trouble. And yeah, he did jump down and landed in an amazing position. It's quite impressive. And there you go, you rested at the first bonfire here. Safe and sound. I'm going to call an episode there, and I'll see you for the next one.